Hi and welcome to another video. My name is Ilse and today I'm going to talk to you a very personal topic. And I'm talking about this because I feel like this would be a great outlet and maybe it would reach someone out there that is going through something similar. I want to apologize for the various things that might happen during this video. 1, me crying. 2, not making a lot of sense. 3, more crying. 4, just really talking about my feelings, I guess. And all of this really starts by me going home. If you guys didn't know, I'm not from where I'm living right now. I'm from a different state in Mexico and I'm currently going to visit my family back home when that's in a few days. Things are gonna be different this year or this Christmas. A few months ago, I lost my cousin to suicide. Apparently he was going through depression, substance abuse, something that I did not know was happening, but now I do. And it was a huge loss. It was shocking. It felt like I was in a nightmare. The first thing that crossed to my mind when I found out was that it can't be, like, he's alive. I mean, what are you talking about? No. I was in denial. And I started crying, obviously. I think my whole world shattered. Because how can someone how could someone take their own life? And the number one question always is why? And the really sad part of making that question is that you'll never get the answer because that person is gone. There's a lot of controversy regarding suicide because other people say it's selfish. It is selfish. And some people say that it's something that it happens all the time. And the real question is here, why is it happening all the time? It shouldn't be happening all the time. There shouldn't be anyone going through this. A lot of people say, how can this affect that person now that it's gone? Well, the thing is, it doesn't affect the person that, well, it's the person that died or took his own life because that person's not there anymore. The real question is how it's going to affect the people around him or her. That person had a life, had friends. She had family, a mother, a dad, brother, sister. That's the real thing. That's who affects suicide, the people around you. And honestly, it's something that I read everything about suicide in books, but it's very different when it happens to you. How do you find the words to tell someone it's gonna be okay? You don't know it's gonna be okay. You don't know what's gonna happen. You don't know anything. And the really sad part about all of this is that people take this as a joke. People think that depression is a joke. People think that anxiety is a joke. People think that mental illness itself is a joke. Didn't we see all of this to the celebrities? Substance abuse, depression, anxiety, etc. We've seen that with Robin Williams, we've seen that with Corey Monteith, we've seen that with a lot of other people, and people still think that mental illness is a joke. Depression is not something to take lightly. It's not something we can just brush off and say the next it's gonna be okay. It's not something that just say it's gonna pass. It's not something you say like, just go out and have fun with your friends, it would just be okay. It's not that simple. It's something that needs to be taken care of. It's something that needs to be talked about more. And the thing that's happening right now is that a lot of people think that all of this is just a joke. That all of this is just something that we do for attention. But when it happens, people are like, oh, if you need to talk to someone, talk to whoever, write it down, listen to music, scream, go for a walk, go running, shout to the wall, I don't know, punch a pillow, do something about it. Don't shush yourself. Don't close yourself. Please talk to someone. You really don't know how much of a difference it makes when you talk to someone and just let everything out. It may not solve your problems, but it may take a huge weight off your shoulders from something that you've been carrying on for weeks, maybe years. I don't know. Things have affected my family pretty deeply. It really has made me really sad lately, and I may not show them to you, like, this facet of mine. But it's not just that. I mean, I've been losing friends. I've been really closed off to a lot of people, and books have helped me. Books have made me really happy. But what happens when I don't feel like reading? What happens then? I'm not saying I'm depressed. I'm not saying I'm suicidal. I'm just saying that I've been really sad for a while. It doesn't mean that I'm depressed. Also, people use the word depressed as being sad, and that's really not good. If you're sad, you're sad. Don't say you're depressed, because clinical depression is way different to just saying that you're sad. But what the point of this video, I guess, is that if you're going through these thoughts about, you know, killing yourself, or that you are really, really sad, or you're going through depression, anxiety, and whatnot, please talk to someone. You can talk to me. I'm a psychology major, but if you just want to talk to me, talk to me. If you just seek help, you really have no idea how much you are affecting the people around you, that care about you. And you're just, not issue, but regarding my cousin, you just have a lot of questions that you're not gonna get the answer to. And there's a lot of anger, a lot of sadness, a lot of confusion. And there's just a lot of things that are going through your mind. And with that, I'm just gonna end the video, and I know this is really, really sad. I am so sorry. But I really just needed to vent and take this out of my chest somehow. So, yeah. If you are still watching this, thank you so, so much. And I promise the next video is not gonna be this depressing. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye.